Tell me up, then the tables and turn. Hold up, tell me up, I think the tables and turn. Forget the bridges we done built, it's time I let them all burn. They tried to kill me out, well now it's the word. I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the third. They kill me out, now kill me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling. Can't even see him from the view. Got my check up, and now I'm tryna blow a bag of two. Proud to shoot, and all designer drip get what I desire. Put him out, it's what I told him, cause that boy he on fire. Walk in that thing and air it up, been in my bag a little bit. Remember my pockets in a drought, I couldn't build a little chick. They say they truly love his paper, you see that's a myth. That's why you catch all my brothers ballin', ain't shooting no bricks. Hold up, check me out, hold up. I think the tables and turn. Forget the bridges we done built, it's time I let him.
Today, from U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, this is Madden Football on EA Sports.
Greg Joseph now ready to get this one started, and we are underway from Minneapolis. Ray-Ray McCloud to return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. As he's up to about the 37. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down. Now it's Roethlisberger. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. And Daniil Hunter, he's the one who gets in there and brings him down to the ground. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
There he goes, left side.
This is
touchdown, Vikings. That down is an 85-yard punt return, and the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead. They get the stop to... force the punt, they score without their offense even stepping on the field.
I remember playing and playing on special teams and teasing the guys on offense, like, look, you don't even worry about it. You guys just hang out over there. We'll bring this one all the way back and get the points we need. In this case, they actually got that done.
So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. McCloud now on the return. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out of it.
And oh, right away, he lost the football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. Under center for the Vikings, out comes the former Michigan State Spartan and longtime veteran Kirk Cousins. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Good move at the 30. Cook, a first down and more. And did he get in? No. Down at the 1 yard line. A big play there.
And that was a big run. It takes them all the way down to the 1 yard line, and that'll shake the confidence of any defense. So when they're looking for a little bit of support now, looking at their defense.
And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. It's Dalvin Cook there with a 1 yard touchdown run. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Everybody in the stadium knew what they were going to do right there, CD. Three tight ends on the field, all that extra bulk, and they run it in.
And you saw where that one went, right? You run it over your best blocker. I can just see the head coach right now. I want to run this one over the big boy. And they got it done.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ballgame as they come up first and 10. Roethlisberger's throw complete to Freiermuth. And I think the ball's out. Second time he's fumbled in this game. Fortunate for him, this one goes out of bounds.
And the key for him now is how much equity have you built up with your coaching staff? How much equity have you built up with your team to continue to get opportunities? Fortunate that one went out of bounds, saved him from a turnover.
And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And this is going to be a Steelers first down as he's got this past the 35 to about the 37. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game. A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked it on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
On second down, this is Harris. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
The ball popped in the air. Oh, he's hit. He lost the football. Put it on the carpet. And the offense is going to get the ball back. After all that, Eck, it'll be a first down. So they escape. So to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about, getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense.
Puts it on the carpet, it's out, and the Vikings pick up the football. Able to slither by. And they are going to bring this one back. It's a fumble return, a scoop and score for the Vikings. So the defense forces the fumble. They get the score, and a guy on defense becoming offensive there, Charles.
And you know they love that. Any guy on defense loves to pick up the ball and have it in his hands and try and score himself. In this case, that's exactly what happened.
He'll be singing in the shower postgame. So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away. McLeod now on the return. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Pittsburgh offense making their way back out.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential.
Without a doubt, because when we see that, that pretty much tells the tale of the game. And I know there's still plenty of time to go, but you've got to take care of the football in order to win it.
Got it here at the 29 on 2nd and 8. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. This will go for 5 up to the 33.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of them
trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
I'm not sure, Brandon, we've seen a sloppier played game this year for a team on offense. Turn it over 4 times and expect to win? No chance whatsoever. And look, I have no idea what the ratio is about turnover 4 times and how that correlates to winning or losing, but I guarantee you, it's not very good.
46 yards rushing for him now on just his first 3 carries. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And this one is incomplete.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
Dancing to his left. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. 21-0, our score after 1. So now after the sack, Cousins and the Vikings come up here 3rd and long. And that is caught. What a grab at the 8. And finally down it goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They'll run with Cook. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the pickup there. 2nd and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And it's caught. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a 3rd and goal. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Dalvin Cook with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings are able to add on to their first half lead. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the 2nd time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack. And you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line. And he's able to take it into the end zone.
Extra point right down the middle. And it is 28-0. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it's capped off by the touchdown run coming from Dalvin Cook. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. The football will come out to the 25 as McCloud will not return it. The Vikings defense getting ready to go. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. The tackle goes to Harrison Smith. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Roethlisberger. Now Ben hit, and he lost the football. It's loose. And this belongs to the Vikings. Every week we hear talk about create turnovers. In particular, they wanted to force some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed over time. It used to be good enough for a guy to get a sack of a quarterback in the pocket. Now, if you come to the sidelines.
And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Dalvin Cook on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Vikings open the lead up to 34-0. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes this 35-0 now. Well, they got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. McLeod now on the return. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and it finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something
heads up
to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. The sack coming from big Dalvin Tomlinson. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Roethlisberger. Two minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. And that is incomplete.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
This Minnesota D up to the task on the third down pass play. And Boswell's kick is good. And they'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted, but I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Well, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason.
Now, that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
Oh, nice move. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 98 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Yeah, and let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting.
It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Tyler Conklin, 29 yards. And the Vikings offense continues to pour it on.
And that was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone. So give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
Joseph now to have the PAT. And the route is on here in this first half. One play, two plays, touchdown. That's all it took there. A very short and sweet drive that got him in the end zone. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. McLeod now on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To throw here, Roethlisberger. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on 3rd down.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. And here comes Westbrook. A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the 2nd quarter.
Deep ball there on 2nd down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
And some room to work. 30.
They are not ready for us.
10. And now they are knocking on the door inside Pittsburgh's 10. A big play there just before halftime. Great run there, but it looked like they were going to have him for the stop. He was able to push through. They didn't wrap up defensively.
No, they didn't. All credit to the runner for making it happen, breaking through some contact and going a long way. But the defensive guys, when they watch this on tape, they're not going to be real happy with themselves. They had a great opportunity that they let slip through their hands.
So, you sure you're ready for the 3rd quarter? You need to use a bathroom? Let's go. The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the 2nd half. Taken at the goal line. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And the Vikings set to go on offense to begin the 3rd quarter. The first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them because if they can add 7 more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
On the carry, it's Cook. And some space here. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. My goodness, 232 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's 1st and goal just outside the 5. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. 1st down, a bit of a disaster, and now on 2nd and goal, back even further. Vikings take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and that will extend this big lead. A drive there of just 4 plays, and it's capped off by the touchdown run coming from Dalvin Cook. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. McLeod now on the return. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
So first and 10. And if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. A huge loss on the play, and that's going to bring up a second and forever. Another carry now for Madison. Shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. Touchdown, Vikings! Alexander Madison, 57 yards. And this Viking offense is running away with this one. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead will swell by one more. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. Two plays later, pay dirt. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. McLeod now on the return. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger. And that throw behind his man. He missed him. Incomplete. Heavy set out there on third and one. On the give, this is Harris. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. The Steelers send out their punter now as he's on to kick it away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Vikings will be backed up deep to begin their drive as they take over first and 10. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line. He'll start by handing it off to Dalvin Cook. And some room to roam now. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A big pickup there on the run. Got to give a nod of appreciation to some of those guys up front over on that left side. Several key blocks sprung him.
No appreciation for the guys from the backside that didn't allow any leakage, anybody could run him down from the backside.
They're at the kids' table.
Okay, so front side guys, good, yeah. Backside guys. Nah. That's what you're supposed to do?
I've had better.
Okay, either way, worked out quite well, didn't it? A nice sizable game.
And a guy that can change the game shows you a glimpse of it right there, taking the ball down inside the red zone.
It just tells you how tough it is for a defense. You just hold on all game and essentially hold your breath. Will they break a big one on us at any point during the game? It just happened right there.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. They'll try to throw now. Cousins. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson.
A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Vikings get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead.
And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Point after, right down the middle. And that will extend this big lead. Just a 4-play drive that time. And it all culminates in a touchdown for Minnesota. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field.
They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
On 2nd down, it's Harris. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on 1st down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on 2nd.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
He'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he will have a Steelers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 3 quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's 2nd down.
So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. Now it's Roethlisberger. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. The Steelers on 3rd down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is 3rd and 10. Short little throw to Ebron. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball. That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
To throw once more on 2nd and 10, Roethlisberger. And this is going to turn into another 1st down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 30.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up 3rd down.
Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. He's got a man open. It's Chase Claypool. And he will have a Steelers 1st down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on 3rd and 3. Finally, a first red zone opportunity for these guys. They have a 1st and 10 at the 18. Roethlisberger going to get that to Ebron. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down. They hand this off to Harris. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. The Steelers on 3rd down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This will be 3rd and 5. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And the Steelers are going to have 1st and 10 as they try to finish off this drive with 6.
So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. Harris. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
Chris Boswell now for the extra point. And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. That drive, a long one, spanning 15 plays.
And it was Najee Harris who finished it off with a touchdown run. Kenny Nwagu now out of his end zone.
And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They'll try and wind down some clock with Cook. Fighting through, and he's got space. Still going. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Boy, I got to say, I don't know how he made